What's up? I don't know if you can hear me. What's up? What's up? What's up? Okay, I had to update the Twitter. I forgot about that. All right. More Phantom Pain. Tomorrow I'll mix it up a little bit, don't worry. But today, got a few hours of Phantom Pain ahead of you. Showtime! Okay, this is going to take a little while to load, as it tends to do. And while that's happening, I'll pause all of the... See, I have to. One of the things I do when I stream is I have to pause the live video. So. Showtime, bro! How you guys been? It's been a few hours. We had practice today. So I was, we had surprisingly good practice. I think Mike and I actually really made some progress and also came up with a few new songs, which won't be on this current album, but it was fun. And, and now here I am, back to Metal Gear Solid. You know, it's funny because it just put me in the world of the game, and then I had to go immediately. And it was like, oh, that is such a fucking tease.
Miller's exact location, so you'll need to do a little intel gathering first. Take a look around Violo Village.
Hers. Look at me, I'm hers. You know, I just, was talking to the chat about the streaming. You know, you'll notice it's 60 frames a second, but every now and then things get a little bit choppy, which is not like that on my end, but only in the recorded, you know, in the recording. It's using 80% of CPU usage, so it's probably the CPU I have to change. RAM being used is about 5 gigs. I just ordered another 8 gigs of RAM, so that's probably not going to help. Looks like the CPU is what's being taxed the most at 60 frames a second. So if you guys have any great ideas for some new RAM, a new CPU, that might be my next big upgrade, so I can stream at 60 frames a second a little bit better. I just posted my specs. i7 4790K minimum. I was thinking about the 4790K, but that's $330. That's a lot of money. So anyway, I'm just kind of going slow, taking this all in.
There's a Soviet guard post. There are bound to be guards. Take a look with your binoculars. Put the enemy in the center of your field of view. That's marking. Focus on a thread and it'll be marked automatically. You can mark enemies and vehicles by zooming in with your binoculars or camera. Once they're marked, you'll also see their positions on the map. Security at that guard post is relatively light. Looks like the perfect place for a warm-up. Try to remember the ways you used to deal with enemies. Anytime you need advice, just give me a call.
Thanks, Shalashaska. So you get a secondary and two primaries. Yeah. Okay, so this is really cool. I'm getting Red Dead Redemption vibes. So this game takes place in Afghanistan. If you weren't here earlier, I did the prologue. Oh, I see some animals. Oh, you're alive. All right, sorry. I won't hurt you anymore. You'll have to live with a bullet, but you'll be all right. I literally just started this. This is my first time in the field. How the fuck do you get off the horse? Oh, why? It's like Grand Theft Auto. Alright, guys. Open world stealth Metal Gear. Solid 3. 3.
Sight, sound, keep all your enemy senses in mind. When you're near an enemy, stay low and move slowly. Don't leave bodies out in the open. Find some place to drop them out of sight.
We're hitting 90% CPU usage. So, yeah, I think that's. Well, I definitely didn't want to do that move. So it's the CPU that's making this happen. Is there a way I could pick up this weapon and have this weapon as well on my second primary slot, or is this just? Oh god, that's not the B button. What are you doing, man? Remember, you have first-person view. Yes, yes, yes. I gotta stop pressing that button, man.
That's a rough diamond. Good find. It'll fetch a high price.
I'll buy it for a high price. Showtime, mother.
Guard post captured.
I never realized how much I wanted a game like this until just today. And I still keep hitting it. The secondary is for, so I can only have, say, a shotgun and a pistol. And not, say, a shotgun, a rifle, and a pistol. Because I like variety. I always like to have different types of weapons. Yo, what? Yeah, don't worry, the Vappy's on the Phantom Pain intro. It'll be much, much, much more watchable. It'll be, like, kind of in one part. A little choppy at times, but not nearly as bad as it was earlier today. Also, is there a way to call the horse? You know, like a Pona? Baby, come back! Oh, I need your horse like I never done need a horse before. Baby, come back. That's not even how the song goes.
Arrived at Mother Base.
Wasn't Mother Base trashed? Oh, I guess they kind of fixed it up in the years to come, right?
Those materials are already processed. They should come in handy sooner or later. Why not start gathering them?
Gotta be honest, I did not expect open-world gameplay. I didn't keep too up-to-date on this game in terms of, like, previews, because I was very behind on the Metal Gear story, and I figured, well, there's no point in getting Phantom Pain if I'm not up-to-date. And then, what do you know, I became up-to-date. Also, you know, this dude right here. First of all, we get a suppressor that I want to save a little bit. You know, look, I captured the base. He was going to wake up sooner or later, and he was going to be like, why is my comrade dead? So that needed to happen. How do you make the horse shit? You need to unlock the horse shitting skill. Are you Are you kidding me? Yeah. So don't mind me for taking this a little bit slow. I want to take it all in. I want to just enjoy what I'm looking at right now. I mean, I know this game is also out on PS3 and Xbox 360, which means they probably had to scale a few things back. But it's still a very, very nice looking game. And this is maximum quality, and I'm running it at 60 frames a second on my end. I don't know if you're seeing that. Is it? How's the frames on your end, guys? Is it stuttering a bit? Also, we're now up to 5.72 gigabytes of RAM in use. And I just was here. I have a question for you guys. The question is... It's smooth, frames are fine, good, 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 okay. The question I have for you guys is, if I get another 8 gigs of RAM, which are on the way, even though my RAM isn't fully being used, will it help? You have 3 days to complete your mission, by the way. Okay, I guess we'll do that then.
You're almost at the enemy outpost, Violo Village. The village is crawling with enemy soldiers. Don't just go waltzing in. Start with some recon. Is there anywhere that overlooks the village?
Okay. Recon. Yeah, this kind of overlooks the village.
How about it? Can you see the village from there? Use the binoculars to recon the place. Look at where the enemies are stationed. Look at their gear. Take it all in. There should be a command post somewhere. See any buildings with tighter security? If there are clues to Miller's whereabouts, I'll bet you can find them in there.
Sun will set shortly. Marker placed.
Why does it happen? Why does the button just, like, stop holding, even though I hold it? It's very strange. Okay, so there's one there. There's two there. How do you play music? Oh. Not an enemy. That's a bush. It's a shame because I would totally play my own music to this if I wasn't streaming this. But you know, I don't want VODs to get muted. I already have enough problems with people putting their fingers in my ass wallets because of a copyrighted thing. How does this work now in this game?
Boss, you don't understand what he said?
No.
I guess that makes sense. Where are you? It looks like that horn stuck in your head has impacted the language center of your brain. If only we had a recruit with a Russian interpreter skill, we could get by with simultaneous interpretation.
Oh, Oh, that is cold-blooded. That is so cold-blooded. Fucking hell.
You have arrived at your destination.
So you're telling me that Big Boss's languages were affected? Alright, fine. I'll buy it. I'll buy it. Just this once. Hello, rat. Oh, right. I don't have my silencer on. God damn it. I took the silencer off like a dick. Very aware of the silencer situation. They're gonna find the body, aren't they? Oh, this is a fun game. I like this game. What the hell does this thing do? Yeah, I figured that out with Ground Zeroes. Got it. I'm worried that this is an alarm. The slowdown shit is when an enemy sees you. Like, it gives you a chance to... kind of cancel the, obtain invoice. Okay, good. That wasn't a switch. It gives you a chance to kind of kill them before they alert everyone on the base.
The enemy's given up their search for you, but they're not giving the all clear just yet. Stay
alert. Ocelot, don't you have anything else to do? Like, how he knows a lot of things about what I'm doing. Why couldn't he just, like, help me? Comrade Ocelot, please. This music, though, is kind of amazing, but also a little bit unnecessary right now.
Cypriots, after all. What about the Turks? They haven't returned to the south. Not yet. The Cyprus dispute is still a long way from resolved. The country is just as split as it was in 74. Turkish Cypriots in the north, Greek Cypriots in the south. Between them, the green line the UN established.
And the Calyas is right on top of it.
90% CPU usage, 6.16%.
Another reason RAM. It was the perfect place to hide you.
So, I'm cutting it close.
Snooping around. So how do things stand?
Now, last year, the Turks declared that the Turkish Republic of Northern Cyprus is an independent state. Though it's only Turkey that recognizes it. In the past, the Greeks and Turks lived side by side in the same villages.
Yeah.
There are reasons to fight. Those came
I'm gonna
to
upgrade
the
both.
Greece, Turkey, Britain, America... They all have their own stake in pitting the two sides against each other. But once you spark something like this, it's impossible to control. Both sides build up grudges like death, without the foresight to see that each act of revenge just fans the flames, and then it's too late for other nations to rush in with peace talks. The embers keep on smoldering. Each nation's arrogance only breeds anarchy. The world is paralyzed by this hunger for revenge. Cyprus is no different.
Can you turn on your...
These cassettes are slightly distracting. How do you?
You're up.
How do you stop them?
We can't go sailing the Suez in a whaler.
How do you?
Suez Canal. When do they reopen it?
Okay. If anyone has any reasonable suggestions for a good CPU, please let me know through email or whatever. The one that has been recommended to me the most is $330, which is... that's a tough swing. I mean, if it'll make my streams look better, and also kind of future-proof my computer a little bit, it's worth it, but that's a lot of money. Jesus. Where am I going? C. Yeah, we're gonna go to C. Another dumb question. Is there a way to... is there a way to call the goddamn horse? I saw it when I was interrogating someone, but I mean, that surely that can't be the only way. Ah, there it is. Thanks. Gotcha. Thanks. Cool. Oh shit! Look at that. He was there the whole time. You motorboating son of a bitch, you. The hill vertically. Nope. We gotta go to Skyrim to get a horse like that, I think. What the hell is this happening to this horse? Making a horse work well in a video game is surprisingly difficult. It almost never looks right.
Boss, taking the scenic route? That's not the way to one day.
I know, sorry.
On your iDroid.
I was just trying to get to sea.
Whoa.
Believe me. There's Hyundai.
Marker placed.
We'll go there. Okay, Ocelot, I gotcha. Yeah, I lost. That was poop. My shots were very, very bad there. I need suppressors. That's what I need. Tactical. Over.
It's an enemy guard post. Watch yourself.
Looking right at me. Okay. Button. Okay, I have to get used to the switching of the things. Let's see, what will be a good way to do this? Yeah, that works.
Guard post captured.
Gotcha, bitch. Set. She blinded me with science. I remember that song. Yeah, let's mute the VOD. Yeah! Legally, due to copyright issues, this is as much as we can play here on Vinesauce BBC 3. The stealth suit. No, I don't think I have a stealth suit. Where? How? I will listen to the after effects of Snake's coma at some point.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
I'll get it later on. It's amazing what the series has become.
You've reached one day. Miller is being held somewhere in that town. But we don't know exactly where he is. You can keep gathering intel or make an entry into the town now.
I need some intel. What the hell is this? Oh, wrong button. Always wrong button.
That's a type of medicinal plant. Bring it back to base. It's sure to be useful sometime.
I like how Ocelot's just sitting against a rock. Just thinking about, like, Snake. Focusing on... You see that? Tell me that's not weird. I'm actually holding down the button. You missed the intel. It was back at the village you were in? Really? Oh, man. So what does that mean? Does that mean... I... will have a harder time with this? Or do I need to go back? Can still get him. Just wander around there and find him. It's no big deal. Okay. Cool. All button. I still think I'm playing Peace Walker half the time. avoid that guy. Once I get a hang of the menus a little bit more, I think I'll be in good shape. Shame about that non-infinite suppressor. If you tap, you can change quickly. Oh, you don't. Right. I see. Thanks. Good. I'll keep that in mind. Stealth.
Survival.
Clearly, this village was built by aliens. Teotihuacan could not have been built by native humans at this time. The rocks fit together perfectly, and that is why I believe the Loch Ness Monster is real. Spongy Peanut Butter says, I got a vine sauce tattoo a few hours ago. It looks sweet. Cool. As long as it's not on your Schlanger, you know, tweet me a picture of it, at Vinny Vinesauce, or you can email it to me if you don't have Twitter. Just doing some recon, looking around. See, it's too dark. Yeah, I didn't see him. Time to run away. Come at me. What the fuck are they shooting at? Tactical stealth action. Whoa. Yeah, see ya. I will attempt the stealth approach again. I'll let them forget about me. They still throwing grenades? No, that's mortars. Whoa, they blew up their own anti-air cannon. Right, let's try that again. It's like, I like the night vision, but I also kind of hate it at the same time. It's not as cool with the night vision on, and things get really bright and annoying, but I'll do it. I'll use it. Like, what am I even... looking at there. That's just a regular light source. I thought it was a spotlight. Yep, they saw me. Trying to throw his friend's body at him. That didn't quite work. What the hell are you guys saying? That was fucking awesome though, did you see that? Yes! Yes, I can do that! That's so fucking cool. On you two. Cuz. I feel like that needed to happen. I didn't want them waking up. Let me just make sure everything's copacetic out here. Okay. Ah, shit. They know I'm here, though. Yo, Kaz's aviators are like 175 quid.
It's me. I'm here to get you out.
Snake.
They do something to your eyes?
No, it's just bright as all.
See the lens flare on the glasses. Now he is complete.
What took you so long?
Yeah, I want those aviators really bad, but I don't want to look like a complete fucking knob wearing them. And that's exactly how I would look.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
You've secured the target. I'll send the chopper to get you out. Make your way to the RV. You can check the location on your iDroid.
Mission info has been updated.
Flurgan.
Well,
Jim Flurgan.
Age hasn't slowed you down.
Marker placed.
Not so heavy anymore, right?
Am I going to G, right? Okay, G is somewhere over there. You don't see me. You don't see me.
Showtime!
Marker removed.
This is Pequot. Have arrived at LZ. We'll
yeah, Pequot.
Support helicopter has arrived.
We lost it all that day.
Yo, where's...
Everything.
Where's Kaz's arm? Guys, did they remove his arm, or is this a glitch? What is that? I didn't see him missing an arm. Wait, is he missing a leg too? Oh no, they took off part of his leg. I just noticed. His arm and his leg, those motherfuckers. Those sons of bitch cunt motherfuckers. How dare they hurt my favorite character? This is fine too, I guess.
Boss, watch out. It's the Skulls. Don't let them find us.
Boss, whatever that mist is, it's all around you. We can't see through it. I'm changing the RV so it's outside the mist. Get over there. The chopper will be waiting.
Come on, horse. Come to me. Horse, please. Horse. Come on, horse. Just make it a little bit higher. Come on. Clip through the. All right, never mind. I'm afraid of these guys. I don't want to fight them. I don't want to be near them. Okay, hang on. They want me over there. Right. Okay, so.
You have arrived at your destination.
I guess I can't go up there at all? Just run past them? I'll run past them then. Yeah, that was my next course of action. That's fucking creepy. What? No! No, you can't do that. This is the 80s. What the fuck? What the fuck? Why are... Okay. Poor Miller's just getting shot. Oh my god, that is...
The mist is cleared, and it looks like they're gone.
That is awful.
Those things. That's the unit that attacked us before. They came at us real fast in the same kind of mist. Our men, survivors from 9 years ago, were wiped out in minutes.
All right, but it was no mistake.
Say because. Goodbye, horse.
Buddy, departing with any other operations. Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
B, codename Chick. Still. Phantom limbs. Wait, huh? What's this? Why do we get credits? Kojima Productions. Kojima. How are you, Kojima Chima? Game over, Kojima Jima. Kojima.
We're headed for the Seychelles. That's where our new home is now. Hey. Some operation we had, huh? 9 years ago. Carving out our own world. Making our own future. And they took it away. I'm gonna rebuild it. Make a new place. Together that we can call home. Yeah, we were dogs, all right. Slinking around out of Cypher's sight, digging up whatever kind of dirty money we could find. You name it, we did it. You see this? Diamond Docks. Our new home. A phantom of our former selves. Triumph.
Death. Good Bowie album.
We weren't allowed either. Yeah. I remember it all.
Barfk, barfk. Do the doggy dance. Back when Kaz and Snake both had all of their limbs. Yes, thank God for that. Why are the flashbacks so low? The volume is so low.
Give my regards to your boss when you get home.
I like that skull. That's a good skull. Snake.
Why are we still here? Just to suffer. Every night.
I've seen starring so many times.
My arm. Even my fingers. The body I've lost. The comrades I've lost. Won't stop hurting. It's like they're all still there. You feel it too, don't you? I'm the one who got caught up with Cypher. A group above nations. Even the U.S. And I was the parasite below, feeding off Zero's power. They came after you in Cyprus.
And Miller's voice actor did a really good job this time around. Cyprus. Jesus.
Just keeps growing. Swallowing everything in its path. Getting bigger and bigger. Take back everything that we've lost, and I won't rest until we do.
Pushing Mother Base.
Tell me like you used to. So many credits, so many starrings, so many created and directed bys, and yet they took his goddamn name off the fucking cover of the game. They are... No one will ever know who created this game, gamer. I wouldn't be surprised if they put those in just to fuck with Konami.
Things have changed, boss. We pull in money, recruits, just to combat Cypher. Rubbing our noses in bloody battlefield dirt. All for revenge. The world calls for wet work, and we answer. No greater good. No just cause. Cypher sent us to hell. But we're going even deeper.
I know. I'm already a demon. Heaven's not my kind of place anyway.
These mother bases look so much like Big Shell.
Of war for 9 whole years. That ends today. Now you're not sleeping, and we're not junkyard hounds. We're diamond dogs.
Let them talk.
Build the army that can do it.
Just one thing, Kaz. This isn't about the past. We're fighting for the future.
It's still weird hearing Kiefer's voice. It's... I don't hate it. I think he's doing a good job. But it's just, David Hayter, man. You've been doing it all this time, and now you're different. Kind of makes me a little sad.
Boss, there's something I want to talk about. The concern you came. This base belongs to you now. Make Diamond Dogs the force it deserves.
Wait, tell me the thing you were going to say.
We need good people, and we need to make good use of their
talent. Tell me the thing.
Miller asked me to lay that out for you. Start bringing people in. Use this. It's a Fulton recovery device. When you're in the field, use it to extract any soldiers or prisoners you want back here. And we'll see if we can't persuade them to join the ranks of Diamond Dogs. Go on. Test it out on the staff here. Anyone you want. First, put them to sleep. You have a tranquilizer gun, don't you?
Let's do this, boss.
Extraction arrived at Mother
Base. You can only Fulton recover someone if they're not resisting. No dead bodies either. They don't make great recruits. The staff member you just extracted will be assigned to the team best suited to his abilities. See for yourself. Open your eye droid.
Peace Walker.
Select staff management from the Mother Base menu.
So that staff member was placed on the R&D team.
Sadistic Mastiff.
Is in charge of developing all kinds of weapons and items.
Oh, wow, this is very Peace Walker-ish.
Take a look at the development list.
Select weapons items under the development heading. What's wrong? Go back to the Mother Base menu. Select weapons items under the development heading.
Please specify.
That's the R&D team's development list. See the item called cardboard box? Didn't seem much use to me, but Miller was adamant that you'd want it on the list. The last word in infiltration technology, or so he said. In any case, we don't have the manpower to develop it just yet. We need more staff on the team. Go extract a few more people. Boss, put the iDroid away for a moment. You can also Fulton extract individuals you've knocked out. Why don't you try knocking someone out with CQC next? Show them how it's done, boss. Try throwing them. It's the best way to knock someone out instantly.
Oh, that's how you do it. Okay. A little different than Peace Walker.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
One thing I should mention, a Fulton extraction won't always be successful. If the person is injured, the shock of it could kill them. And if the weather's unfavorable, well, they could end up going missing. You can determine the chance of success by approaching the person you want to extract. If you want to be sure you can get them out, best carry them to the chopper instead. All right, extract the next staff member.
The success rate is affected by the weather. Avoid conditions like sandstorms and rain. Jesus. Subject's status of their health too, yeah.
Any punches. Use any method you like. Start by knocking them out. Or you can put them down.
I'm ready.
Go for them, not me.
Extraction arrived.
That's enough.
The base. Unit function added. Development project has been added.
Now that we have more people on the R&D team, its level has gone up. They should be able to follow the cardboard box now. Open your eye droid.
Select weapons items under the development.
Now select cardboard box and start
development.
Be aware that development requires funds. GMP. Watch we don't end up in the red.
Development has finished.
Please select a drop point.
You can have the support unit supply you with weapons and items you've developed. Think of it as your own personal delivery service.
Your own personal Jesus delivery service. Oh, look! Would you look at that? It's a Fulton. Nah, it's a little parachute. Little parachute fella. And then it burns up! Oh, that's awesome. I like that.
And there it is. Not sure what it's good for, but Miller said you know what. Try it out. One last thing. The staff members you extracted were all placed on the R&D team, but that was Miller's decision. If you think they belong somewhere else, feel free to move them around. Well,
mission info has been updated.
You'll find recruits hanging around here. Board the chopper when you're ready for a mission. Open your iDroid and select a landing zone to tell it where to pick you up. Or if you're still in the mood for knocking guys on their asses, you can stay around here a while. Give the men some practice. Just come pay me a visit. This isn't the time.
Boss,
let's practice your CQC. Begin by grabbing. Once you grab someone, you're free to do as you like. Interrogate him, knock him out, kill him. Scratch that last one for me. Go ahead and knock him out. Good. Extract the staff.
It's an honor, boss.
It's an honor to be knocked out by you, boss. That's cool.
It's an honor, boss.
Oh, you have limited boxes. That's interesting. What do you want me to do?
Good. Go on and extract it.
It's an honor, boss.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
Pretty sure I already did that. See ya.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
2 + 2 = 5. 2 + 2 = 5.
Starting to feel like yourself again?
Yep.
The rest will fall into place with some time in the field. Go ahead and call the chopper from your iDroid.
Feeling like myself. As soon as I start shooting Ocelot, you know things are good.
Please, the landing zone.
This is B-Quad. Arriving shortly at LZ.
On station at LZ! Training. Hallelujah. I think he's talking in Japanese now. For old time's sake. Remember when we used to trank each other up the pee holes? So this is the new mother base, huh? Pretty fucking cool.
Extraction arrived at mother base. Development project has been added.
Oh my god. Well, we got the sneaking suit. This mission brought to you by the letter C. Starring! Oh, that is wonderful. It happens so often.
Diamond Dogs has received and made a list of those I want you to consider. Which ones you accept is your call. The objectives of the missions I've added are prisoner rescue, facility sabotage, and high-value target elimination. Probably all a walk in the park for you, but they should help you get back on your feet. I put the mission details on a cassette tape. Refer to it if you decide to accept the mission. We'll receive GMP for completing missions. And extracting soldiers and prisoners will boost our ranks. Building up Mother Base is the first step to achieving our goal. If that means wet work, so be it. We're gonna have to get our hands dirty. I hope you're rested up, because we're not stopping. Not until the pain is gone. The future of Diamond Dogs is in your hands. We're counting on you, boss.
Cause the pain will never go away.
Miller told me about what happened in the Caribbean 9 years ago. You do remember Miller. You formed a private army with him. An army with no allegiance to a nation.
I want to know about this.
I see. You're not sure what's fact and what's a fantasy caused by the coma. It's still all a mess, huh? All I can do is tell you the facts as they were told to me. I've gone easy on you up until now. But this is where the hard stuff begins. 1974, the year before you entered your coma. You were in Colombia, operating with a small unit of men, basically mercenaries. Miller was among them. Miller was trying to find a way to turn his and your talents into a line of work. He was looking to start a business where you would fight on behalf of others around the world, those who needed military force. But the reality was, at that time, you didn't have enough gear to equip your own men. Then Miller came across this client. It was a huge job he was offering, but you had a shot at pulling it off.
You Steve Bloom.
And headed into Costa
right.
Rica.
Yeah, we did this.
The client even threw in an offshore facility in the Caribbean. The Mother Base. That would be your new base of operations. Miller sure did have a head for business. As your mission went on, your unit grew and grew. More weapons, more money. Before you knew it, you were commanding 300 men. As the organization got bigger, your military power swelled to match. It got so the international community couldn't afford to ignore you. You were just too damn successful for your own good. You, your men, had worn out your welcome. Everyone was out for you. East, West, First World, Third. It was only a matter of time before someone took you down. And that was XOF. Officially, they're an anti-terror unit under the
I don't think
CIA.
I'll be streaming the entire game, by the way. Seems like I can do side missions on my own.
They lured you to Cuba.
I'll try to do story, mostly.
The Nicaraguan revolutionary kid, and Paz, a mole who worked for Cypher as bait. While you were gone, XOF, posing as a nuclear inspection team, stormed Mother Base. At the same time, C4 they placed on the strut legs went off. The whole thing went down in minutes. XOF. Kisses and hugs followed by a big F-U. All because of Miller's blind spot. A back door into Mother Base no one suspected. You remember a certain scientist. Huey was responsible for bringing the inspection team on board. Giving the enemy a perfect opportunity to hit you at home. You were returning from Cuba when it happened. Mother Base came damn close to taking you with it into the Caribbean. Those of your men out on assignment returned right away. They refused to believe the wreckage in the water they found was Mother Base. But they checked the coordinates again and again until reality finally settled in. You were supposed to die that day. That was XOF's primary objective. As far as most folks know,
kill Big Boss. Did.
The first doctor to see you wasn't even sure what he was looking at. Before they'd even finished operating, your men moved you to that hospital in Cyprus. There was a woman named Eva who arranged that. Rings a bell, huh?
Hmm.
Most men in your condition would have been written off right from the start. But you survived. You went straight down to hell, and they pulled you out. Your eye wide open. Full of venom. The days of Naked Snake are long gone. Welcome back, Venom Snake. This world still needs you. Here, Snake, try this on.
A prosthetic arm.
Yeah, Miller was calling it the arm that wasn't there. The physiotherapy's going well. Your arm's bulked up enough for it to fit. There. Perfect. A little time with it, and it'll work better than the real thing. What do you think?
Huh. I can still feel my real arm.
Well, you better get used to this one quick. You have any pain?
Every now and then.
Where?
My fingertips. My left fingertips.
Sounds like phantom pain. Your brain still remembers your old hand.
Yeah.
What about your vision? Can you see okay?
Yeah, at the moment.
Now, the shrapnel in your skull is pressing on your optic nerve. I'm told any hard impact could have an effect on your visual cortex.
Yeah, the doctor mentioned that.
Your brain might process visual information incorrectly. In other words, you could have hallucinations. You might see things that aren't there, or not see things as they really are. You experience any of that?
I think so.
When?
Right after I wake up. Colors look faded.
Colors, huh? Well, that's not a major concern in and of itself, but it could mean the difference between life and death in the field. You'll need to watch out for that.
I will.
All right. You should continue your physio. We'll be arriving soon. It's the last chance you'll get.
So yeah, that's what happened directly after. World affairs over 9 years. The moniker Shalashaska.
Ocelot. I hear they started calling you Shalashaska in Afghanistan. What's that about?
You know the term Shirashka? It's slang for a suspicious, hastily thrown together organization. The word became associated with a type of forced labor facility in the Soviet Gulag system. OKB scientists and engineers who'd been convicted of crimes were sent to a Shirashka for forced R&D. The Shirashkas were supervised by Lavrenty Beria of the NKVD, the secret police, under the official name 4th Special Department.
Forced research? That's not very different from what we do here.
Diamond Dogs is different. Everyone here believes in you. Regardless of where they came from or why they're here, they revere you. And they're fighting because it was their choice.
And if it wasn't, they'd leave?
Who knows? That's our reality here, whether it's real or not. If there's another truth, I don't want to know it. All that matters is that's the concept that's taken shape in their heads. The traces of a group ideology, our superstructure, to put it in Marxist terms.
All right. Go on.
Right. So anyway, at some point the enemy started calling me Shirashka. This was after the war in Afghanistan broke out. While I was keeping an eye on you in that hospital, I was also heading up interrogations here. The men I broke gave up their comrades and families, everything they wanted to protect the most. No real cause for it. I just let myself get caught up in the old Russian pride. And suddenly I received the honor of becoming special interrogation advisor to the forced labor camps. But the more men I interrogated, the more people saw me as just that, the interrogator. It helped cover my real objective of keeping you safe.
You went that far for me?
Far enough to keep you alive. I ended up being pretty well known among the Afghan guerrillas. Some of them would have seen me on the battlefield. And that's how I got the second half of the name. Shashka. It's a sword. A type of saber from the Caucasus. Russian dragoons and Cossacks carried them into battle. Now, the Russian Empire had a general by the name of Fyodor Artorovich Keller. His bravery earned him the nickname Russia's Greatest Shashka. Someone must have known about that, because somewhere along the line, Shashka got stuck on the end of Shirashka. The guerrillas were using the name amongst themselves, and by the time I got to hearing about it, pronunciation had wound up as Shalashashka.
So, half gulag, half hero sword. It was a perfect fit.
But you see how rumors and ideas about people can get out of hand fast. Once you create a character and put it out there in public mind, it warps and twists with every baseless rumor.
Mm-hmm.
And before you know it, all people see are phantoms. In my case, it works out just fine. I'm plenty used to working under aliases.
Man, I was able to, like, take a selfie while I was listening to all that, but that was cool as fuck. Maybe I'll hold off on some of the tapes until I get to the ground so we have something to look at. Where is Zero and meeting Ocelot? Oh, those are the... Yeah, so those are the two I want to listen to once I get to Afghanistan. How do I get to Afghanistan?
Please select a mission.
A hero's way.
Mission accepted. Heading to Afghanistan.
Oh, yeah, drop at this position. I'm gonna post the selfie that I took on my Instagram. The selfie of me streaming. Hang on. This will be weird. This will be really weird. hang on. I'm almost ready. It's such a dark selfie, but this would be like a fucking selfie-ception. Right, caption. Live selfie. What is my life? Hashtag end me. No, hashtag vine sauce. Upload failed? What? Hang on a second, guys. Yep, it's been posted. Vine_sauce. Enjoy. Alright, select equipment. Primary weapons. At the moment, I really don't have a lot to choose from, huh? Can I equip something else instead of a bionic arm? Hey, let me see if this worked. Yeah, it did. Yeah, cool camera quality, huh? That's the forward-facing camera. It's shit. Tools. I guess I have everything else, so... Fulton. Select character. You can be a different character. What the hell? Tiger stripe. Olive drab. Plus scarf. Or tiger stripe plus scarf. Yeah, it looks cool. Head option. Select a vehicle. Vehicle is horse. Select a buddy. Oh, wait, no. That's the horse. Wow, this is so much more intricate than I thought it ever would be. Yeah, quality Instagram selfies. What up? That is a horrible quality picture. Holy shit.
Spetsnaz detachment commander. Your orders are to take him out. With skills like his, it'd be a shame to waste him. But I'll leave the method up to you. Boss, make your way to Dishago Calais and eliminate the target.
Nice to hear Kaz giving the orders again. Created and directed by Hideo Kojima. Don't forget to give Snake a shower. Oh, okay. I have to worry about giving Snake a shower. What the fuck? When did Metal Gear become this?
We can use compounds from plants to make medicine or poison for use in new weapons and equipment. Take a look at the plants list on your iDroid to see which ones we need. Then go find them if you get...
Phantom Cigar.
...the chance. It'll keep the staff happy, too.
Whoa. So I want to hear a cassette or two, perhaps. I want to hear Ocelot talk about...
I first met you 20 years ago now.
Yep.
The place was Selenoyarsk in the Soviet Union.
It's a mouthful.
We were enemies. I was with the GRU. You were still fighting for America. 1964. Operation Snake Eater. Its objective? Assassination of the legendary soldier known as the Boss. When you returned home successful, they awarded you the title Big Boss. Your CEO
Big
Zero
Boss.
Sought to carry on the boss's will by covertly establishing his own organization. You knew the original members from Operation Snake Eater. From America, there was David O, or as he was to you, Major Zero. Donald Anderson, aka Sigint. Dr. Clark, who went by a paramedic during the operation. And the fourth, you.
Yep.
From China, there was Eva. And me, Ocelot, from the Soviet Union. Six in total. To us, government notions of friend and foe were
supply
meaningless.
Complete.
As were East and West. We joined forces by our will alone. Our objective was to fulfill the boss's dying wish. To make the world one. And to do it, Zero used the Philosopher's Legacy. The secret war fund you obtained during Operation Snake Eater.
Mm-hmm.
This organization would go on to become Cypher. I, on the other hand, was left with the problem. You only recovered half of the legacy. I had to locate the other half myself. When I found the funds, I passed them on to Zero, just as you wanted. I still trusted him in those days. We thought what he was doing was the boss's will. Until he started that one project. Les Enfants Terribles. Zero called it.
The cloning.
Ways. As did Eva, leaving only Anderson and Clark still with him. I maintain limited contact. Although, truth be told, we were just keeping tabs on one another. The reason was always you. After you returned to the army and created Foxhound, you left America. For a time, even I'd lost track of you. I'd imagine Zero did too. You always were the best when it came to hide and seek. Zero created Cypher, an information network to tap into every corner of the globe. Woven together, Cypher's arteries make the world just one big organism. And that's not all. It also monitors the thorn in Zero's side. That's you, tracking your coordinates wherever you might go. The further you strayed from your roots, the larger Zero became. It's as if he was trying to close the gap between you. But before long, he disappeared from public life. Only a few people had direct contact with him. For a time, I was one of them. Then a year after you fell into your coma, he slipped out of sight entirely. Since then, nothing. No photos, no recordings, not even a reliable rumor as to his whereabouts. I tried every method I could think of, but Zero was gone.
Supply drop complete.
Freed of his control, his creation, his power continued to grow. Cypher is a great beast, and Zero was its spine. But even without him, it's endured, evolved. But now its body is rotting, riddled with parasites. Parasites like the ones who attacked you 9 years ago in the Caribbean, and then at the hospital. Cypher's Black Ops unit, XOF. They learned where you were, and came to wipe the slate clean.
It's crazy how Major Zero ended up becoming a major prick. Like, he seemed like such a cool guy. He liked James Bond and everything. But, yeah, it turned out to be a huge cockknocker.
You've arrived at the objective. Your target should be somewhere in that outpost. And don't forget, he has a Spetsnaz recon detail with him. Mm-hmm. Keep your guard up.
Does the sneaking Shago pod, big boss, does anyone know if, the sneaking suit makes you a little harder to see? Shogo Hood. Naked Snake. Fuck that guy. He's ruined Metal Gear for me. It makes your footsteps silent. Ooh, that's useful. I missed a diamond? Really? Hell, diamonds are just hanging out? In the middle of nowhere? Oh, look at that. They're just... Yeah.
Those are raw diamonds. Collecting them as assets will raise our GMP.
I see now. Bad shot. Good shot. So this game is kind of amazing.
Those materials have already been processed. It may not be much, but we can use them straight away if you bring them back to base.
The Fulton is always amazing. I love it. Each and every time.
Roger that.
Yeah. Hey. Do I have infinite Fultons? Because if I didn't, that would kind of blow, wouldn't it? also a satellite dish here. I wonder if there's anything special about this. Doesn't look it. Oh, you have like 12 or 13? You can blow up things around the base. You can upgrade it to hold more Fultons. Cool. You guys are very helpful tonight. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. This is awesome. That got their attention. Sandstorm.
So a sandstorm's come in. Sandstorms effectively make you blind and deaf. But that goes for the enemy too. Use the situation to your advantage.
Up, or when the sandstorm passes, rather. Oh, I didn't even see the number of Fultons the last time I did it. I don't know why. I don't know how I missed it.
Giving up their search for you, but they're not giving the all clear just yet. Stay alert. So your suppressor is worn out. That gun will be as loud as any other now. If you have to shoot, be careful.
Jesus. Suppressor, right? Suppressor can be attached or removed. Almost positive I don't have any more. I don't have any more suppressors.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Also, I'm pretty sure I put the enemy on like high alert. Get out, Snake. Don't do that. That's stupid. Don't be stupid. A little different than Peace Walker, the way the smoke grenades function. Gotta get used to that.
Понял. Оставайтесь на чеку. That's the target. Either destroy that, or turn it off to shut off all the lights and surveillance cameras in the outpost. Target secured. I'll tell the client we sent the target to a place outside of heaven. Boss, your objective's complete. Exfiltrate out of the hot zone by chopper or on land. Don't hang around.
Give me that cassette. Kids in America? I don't think I know that song, actually. Alright, so... I probably shouldn't hang around, but... You know, I'm looking for things that I could pick up and bring back to the base. Gotta make sure I have plenty of rocks for Ocelot to smoke.
I don't know if you know this about me, Joe Rogan. I smoke rocks. I smoke the rocks, Joe Rogan.
Yeah. Go ahead. Get the fuck out of here. Not good enough. Not good enough. So, exfiltrate means I gotta find an area to call the chopper, yes? Like... Uh-oh. Oh, they sent a flare up. Subtitles. Subtitles are on. It just doesn't... The foreign language doesn't translate for some reason. I don't know why. I think I just did that.
Alright, the coast is clear. Mission complete.
Oh, right, you gotta get the translator at your base. That's correct. Ocelot was talking about that.
Development project has been added.
Mission complete.
Oh, the battle dress. Oh, B rank. Starring. Obtain cassette tape. Support helicopter armament can now be developed.
How you feeling, boss? Getting used to being in the field again? Having choppers and horse at your disposal is indispensable for operating in the wilds of Afghanistan. I've gone ahead and arranged for you to be able to develop and customize weaponry for support choppers. And you can also develop new equipment for D-Horse if you like. Use your iDroid to start development as needed. Remember the guys you brought back from the base in Cuba 9 years ago? Believe it or not, some of them survived that hell we went through.
Word like Hideo.
Big boss is back and they want it in. They're good men. Our brothers in fate. They'll be glad to know you've seen them here.
Amber Fox. Gold Fox. Hungry Crocodile, he's, yeah, not that great. Grizzly Hedgehog is fast, but he kind of sucks. Let's see, we've got, Ochre Chameleon, whatever that means. Elite Soldier, we got, oh shit, Silent Mastodon, we extracted him. I think that was the target earlier, I think. Sly Bear. Bastard Mammoth. Bloody Wallaby. This is really like the best of Peace Walker and the best of, I don't know, every other game. All jammed up into one huge package.
The side ops list is comprised of problems we need you to resolve. Objectives to be completed, and information gained from the soldiers and prisoners you've extracted. These aren't missions per se, but if you can take care of them when you're free, I'd appreciate it.
Yeah, I could do that, cuz. Let's do the one for the translator. So we have the iDroid development here. We can develop a few things. I want to develop some things.
Please specify a project.
Effective range damage. Long barrel. Lower option slot. Flashlight stopping power up. I mean, I use this pistol a lot, so... Oh, I need... R&D team. Why don't we take a look at the team? Staff management, right? So I have a bunch of staff members. Is this like Peace Walker, where I could just kind of auto-assign?
Staff assigned.
Okay, so... Support unit. Got these fellows. We've got, Silent Mastodon's in the brig. But I guess, what happens? He eventually... kind of comes around, maybe?
Sun will rise momentarily.
Oh look, Nile Crocodile's here. Oh no, sorry, that's Dire Crocodile. So, like I was saying, there's a chance I won't be playing this whole game on stream. Like, some of the missions I might end up doing off stream because there's just so many of them, really. And I figure it's such a huge game that if I just do kind of the story missions for the stream, that should be fine. And also, I could see myself just wandering around on my own for fun, so I might... I'll split it up. I figure it's a huge, huge game. I don't mind doing some of it offline. I'm sure you guys won't. But we'll hit the necessary elements, don't worry. And if I detect a side mission's becoming a story mission, maybe I'll pause it or something. I don't know. Sniper rifle I could get. Flare gun, C4. Well, let's get the sniper rifle, shall we?
Please, sir, supplies requested.
While that's on the way,
whoa.
We'll check out the mission, side op missions. Extract interpreter. Now that's something we want.
Marker removed. Marker placed. Supply drop complete.
The interpreter. If we could do that, we could see what the fuck other people are saying. So, like I said, I had no idea. I had no expectations for this game. I'm stunned that it's an open-world game. I'm actually kind of sad it's open-world in some ways, because... part of me wants, like, a nice, kind of straight-through, linear, like, story. Kind of like Metal Gear Solid 3. But, I mean... that's just for streaming purposes. For fun? This is amazing. I love it. Well, like I said, I didn't do any research about this game. I didn't know what the hell was going on. I thought we were just gonna get like a linear kind of 15 to 20 hour game and story. That was it. I didn't follow its development. But I think this is better than I could have expected. The only reason I say I'm sad is just from a streaming standpoint, this is going to be a hell of a long stream. That's why I want to do some of it on my own. Kind of like I did with Peace Walker, except more extensively than Peace Walker, because this is... It seems like a longer game than Peace Walker. Do we have here? There's a dog. Find the source of the barking. Okay. Okay, looks like I broke the Fulton. Also, I don't have very many Fultons left. Oh, I held the button. I didn't mean to actually Fulton it. I'm a dick. I need to find this dog so I can puke on it. That's how I play Metal Gear. I heard it. Oh, dog. Hey, little buddy. I'm gonna send him to space! See you back at the base, little buddy!
Roger that. We'll pick him up. Yeah.
That was the best thing I've ever seen. Alright, this is gonna be a stealth mission. Yeah. Vinny, do you know what that you just committed is up, dog?
I know what you want me to say, and I won't give you the satisfaction.
So I'm gonna ask you a question. What's up, dog? Dude's got some pretty intense sight.
Come on!
completed.
Part of me feels like I should have used the helicopter for that. But it was a success.
Boss, that language specialist you extracted has been very cooperative. Says he's always dreamed of living a free life like folks in the West. What are the odds, huh? I've gone ahead and placed him in the support unit. His job is Russian interpretation. Now you'll know what Soviet soldiers are saying. You can even interrogate them. Should give you an edge in the mission.
Okay. He was very cooperative. He got here 15 milliseconds ago. But he's... Trust me, he's got this. He's in. We learned all of that. Oh, sorry, boss. We were talking about the dog you extracted. Thanks, Kaz. So how do I get more supplies? So I'm running out of Fulton's.
Please specify a project.
You know what I really want? I really want like a single shot rifle. Without a scope. Something like Red Dead. I want to be John Marston again. I guess the sniper rifle's pretty cool for now.
Please select a drop point. Supplies requested.
Oh, you spend... That's right, you spend resources when you request things like that. That makes sense.
Supply drop complete.
I wonder why no one shoots these things down. I can. Oh man, where did all of it go? Oh no, what have I done? Oh, that's not too bad. However, someone heard me. I don't know who heard me, but... So, I was curious about something. Development of buddy equipment.
Please specify a project.
Battle dress for the horse. It's expensive, but I mean, it'll keep the horse alive, right? Okay, missions.
Please select a mission.
Well, what's nearby? That's the question.
Mission accepted. The map has been updated.
That's close enough for me to do. The battle bikini. That's my favorite. That's good. Good armor. Battle bikini. It leaves nothing to the imagination. However, it's shit at armor. It's good titty armor, though.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
Say, boss, you see many animals in the field. Truth is, an environmental NGO has asked us to remove wild animals from combat zones. If you have the time, can you extract some back here? There's a reward in it for us.
Whoa!
What the hell is this? Oh, that's an extraction point? Wait, what?
Disable the Soviets' reinforcement system by putting a hole in their base.
Credits are here again.
Network. Head for the Eastern Communications Post and destroy its comms equipment. First, use the binoculars to locate the communications equipment at the facility.
Marker placed.
Ha! Okay, so, oh my god, yeah, I guess we'll head over that way. If I find any wild animals on the way, I'll be sure to shoot them in the fucking head. And, you know, just in case. And that way we can get that reward that they want for saving the animals from combat zones. Save the animals from combat zones. I love the noises. You know, just fucking send them into the sky on a balloon that may or may not crash into the ocean on the way, along the way. Listen to the noise, listen. Oh, I love this game a lot.
Extraction arrived at the mother base.
Nice sniper rifle. Loud as fuck, but nice. I feel like I was at this guard post earlier in the game. Yeah, I think I was, actually. But I guess guards came back. Wow. Yes, welcome to Can't See Shittistan. The best of all the Middle Eastern countries. There's a diamond in that outpost? Oh, fuck. Looks like we're gonna go back and get it.
the Wood by Sunstorm. My favorite band. It's the Wood.
Where's the diamond? Did I get it already? Totally lame. The mortar? How can the Fulton lift an entire man? Oh, look, there it is. It lifted an entire man, but it can't lift a mortar. That doesn't look as heavy as a person. Anyway, onward.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
Anyway, Squidward. I gotta keep a better weapon equipped for when I get caught like that, because the trank just doesn't cut it.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Arrived at your destination.
Okay, I'm at the outpost. I gotta say, the PC version of this game runs pretty well. I've heard issues of corrupted save files, but I haven't seen anything like that so far. That's a little off-putting, to say the least. Fucking dudes here. Someone's listening to music down there. Really good sound design, by the way. Like, really, really good. That actually sounds like something from a distance. It's not just low in the distance, it actually sounds distant. I wonder if they'll notice. Oh, come on. Ah, you fuck. Controls fucked me. I got fucked by the controls. Tell you what I need to do. I need to get that option where I can go into first person mode immediately while aiming. Just like GTA, actually. Getting the fuck out of here. When do I get the ability to turn into a flaming whale? Give this a shot. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, that works for me. See, while they're off looking over, this is all part of the plan. While they're off looking over there, I'm gonna sneak in from the other side. Yes, very, very good plan that I had.
That antenna is one of the targets. There should be more. Keep looking.
Wait, am I supposed to destroy this? Because that's going to make a lot of noise. Alright, why don't I take care of some of these enemies first, and then I'll start worrying about the satellite's dishes. Yeah, there's a few more. They see his body. Did I not just shoot him in the face? Oh.
If you have to shoot, be careful.
Shit. I'm not fucking around anymore, guys. I tried it twice, couldn't do it. I wasn't stealth enough. I know what Granada means. Good, Vin. Shoot the truck. Very good.
Outpost captured.
Fuck, it took long enough. Gotta put this old dog down. When it says extraction failed, it means they're dead. Ceilings matter now? Oh, you can't Fulton people through ceilings now?
You gotta extract him.
Shit. I think we're good.
Good. That's the first one. Destroy the remaining antennas.
I like how the delivery of Kaz's lines are a little bit more spiteful, bitter.
Nice. That's the second one. That wasn't the last of them, though. Keep going.
Dude's a good voice actor.
Good work. You've completed your objective. Now get out of the hot zone.
Mission info has been updated.
I want to look around first. I just realized I have a box. I should have used that. That would have been good. Anyone getting Far Cry 4 flashbacks with me picking up the propaganda posters?
You have arrived at your destination.
Destroy that last one? I did, didn't I? Wait, you guys see another one? You mean this? I really gotta develop C4.
You destroyed their anti-air radar? It wasn't one of the targets, but that's put a hole in their air surveillance. The chopper will be able to get in close now. You can designate a landing zone near the outpost.
Cool. Yeah, I didn't see it because I thought it was just another of the same. I didn't realize it was, a different looking thing.
Please specify a project. Please select a drop point.
Yeah, we're not gonna do that right now. Not while there's a storm. What I want to do is, I'm going to do a story mission. Or a main mission or whatever. Oh, I did. Okay, so this was its own separate thing. I got confused. All right. You have to leave the zone first. Okay. Return to Mother Base. All right. Yeah, I'll do that. I'm gonna, after this, after Mother Base, I'm probably gonna call it a night. Kind of really enjoying this game. Sorry if the commentary isn't overly colorful tonight. I just really getting into the game.
Please select a land support helicopter.
Roger.
Requested. Extraction arrived at Mother Base.
Whoa!
Development project has been added.
Whoa!
Oh, we got new development.
Please specify a project.
Cool. Binocular.
Sun will set shortly.
Can upgrade this, the trank. What's this thing? Oh, grenade launcher. Another cardboard box. iDroid.
This is B-Quad.
Speaker function.
Arriving shortly at LZ.
On station at LZ. don't think I have Fulton upgrades yet. Hey, I heard Mad Max was actually pretty decent. I watched a little bit of it too. It was someone was streaming it. I watched it and I was with it. I thought it looked pretty cool. It doesn't look like the best game ever made, but it looks like it's kind of in the right direction. You know what I mean? Like they didn't. Oh, I got a C on that. Yeah, they got caught a lot. That makes sense. Just give me one second, guys. I want to check something. Let's just see how many people there on Twitch. 17,000 people are streaming Metal Gear Solid 5. It's the third most played game right now. I am the third most popular MGS5 streamer, which is amazing, but also a little bit surprising. Thank you guys for being here. Really though, that's a lot of people streaming one game. It's the fifth most popular game on Twitch right now. Number one is, of course, League of Legends, Hearthstone, then Dota 2, Until Dawn. I don't even know what that is. Haven't looked into it. Counter-Strike is after MGS. There's some Diablo 3 going on too, and Mad Max. Gears of War? There's a new Gears of War game? What the hell? I guess I really haven't been paying attention, have I? Interesting. I was just curious. Kind of like to see what's popular every now and then, see what people are playing. And on YouTube Gaming, there. What else? What's going on there? Mainly just me. And then a few other folks. Mostly Metal Gear Solid 5. Anyway, let's check out Mother Base. Interdasting. Intradasting.
Our army is growing like crazy thanks to you, boss. In fact, it's getting downright crowded around here. To bring a greater number of people on board, we'll need to expand our facilities. To that end, I've created a base development unit. It has two roles, material refinement and platform construction. I'll start with the material refinement part. The base development unit procures material resources on a regular basis according to its level. The materials are stored in containers and placed on the deck of Mother Base. Once they're finished being processed, they can finally be put to use. By using these materials to build new platforms, we'll be able to add a greater number of staff to our ranks. We don't need any specific instructions from you to refine the materials. But I want you to be the one to decide how we construct platforms. Once we have sufficient GMP and the required material resources, you can issue construction orders from your iDroid.
Okay. Some fairly crappy guys. But still.
For a long time in the field is bad.
Workers, nonetheless.
I think it's time you took a break. Do it for me. Come back to Mother Base ASAP.
I mean, yeah, I can do that, Kaz. For you, I'll do it, sure. Anyone else? Fuck them. Fuck them. Thank you, Telepipe.
Come back!
Hello, dog.
Mitch.
Here's the dog you brought back. Bit of a troublemaker. Not sure about the breed, though.
He'll get bigger?
Uh-huh. Like this.
You know, I'd be slightly worried about this dog.
He's still a pup, so he doesn't listen. I have a feeling someday he'll be useful. I suspect, like, you discovered a real diamond in the rough.
He's on an oil platform.
A little polish. I'd say we got a true diamond dog on our hands.
Yeah. 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 Name drop.
Don't squeeze too hard, Snake, with that mechanical hand.
Right. Ocelot raising hounds. Fine.
Just don't jump off,
Dee Dee.
Like, seriously, don't jump off. Look, there's no guardrails. The poor dog. I'd be terrified for that thing. Snake just stood there smoking for a half a day.
Boss, we've received a back channel request from Langley. We're to find a piece of new American military hardware that's gone missing in the mountains of Afghanistan. It's a difficult mission, but I'd say you're back in top form by now. Check your iDroid for the details.
Welcome home.
Hey, here's a plot point that I'm pretty sure hasn't been addressed yet. Zeke and the missile, Metal Gear Zeke, and the nuke are still at the bottom of the ocean. There's water at the bottom of the ocean. Out of my way, asshole. Returning frequently is a good way to increase staff
Boss,
morale.
Do you think you could bring back more medicinal plants? Boss!
Yeah, I can bring back more medicinal plants, quote-unquote, sure. Stand next to the falling boxes sign. XOF stole Zeke and the nuke. This doesn't work. Not that one? Oh, okay. Where's the shower? I need a shower! Oh god! Oh god, I'm filthy! Where is it? Where is it? Do you know where the shower is?
Good day, boss.
Where is it? Oh god! Get me into the shower. Find me a shower, quick! Oh, I smell like Bigfoot's dick. I smell like Big Dick's foot.
Marker placed. You have arrived at
Boss,
your destination.
That you saved, his family down.
Thanks, bro. Night crocodile. Still no Nile crocodile, Boss. But... it's not a whole lot else to do here, is there? So is this guy, like, still being a dick?
Staff assigned.
He wanted me to salute him. I tried to salute him, but I ended up choking him out instead. How do you salute?
The puppy's training is going well. There'll come a day when he'll be ready to join you on missions. But you know, he gets lonely easily. You should come visit him every once in a while.
This guy's been waiting for me to salute him for so long.
Train with me, boss. How about it?
Oh, that's interesting. I can't salute him. I want to salute them, but... How's that for solution? The final solution.
Thanks for that, boss.
You're welcome. Where's my puppy? I need to see the puppy. I already miss the dog.
Boss, let's develop something.
Where are your friends?
It's an honor being held in your iron grip, boss.
Thanks for that, boss.
You're welcome. Wait a minute. Was that a chick? Yeah, that was a chick, and she had a man voice. Thanks for that, boss. Oh, wait, maybe that was different. Never mind. Doesn't matter. It's fine. They're gonna be fine. They are soldiers. This is all part of their training regime. And here I was worried about the dog falling off.
Quit kidding around. Snake?
Oh, I had to press a button. I just kind of zoned out.
Boss, we've received a back channel request from Langley. We're to find a piece of new American military hardware that's gone missing in the mountains.
I gotta shower again.
It's a difficult mission, but I'd say you're back in top form by now. Check your iDroid for the details.
So, someone said stand next to a sign with falling boxes. Is that still something you want me to do? Is it worth it? Yeah, no. You're I'm going up, you're going down. Only one of us, only one of us is going to be going the right way, and it's me. That's fine. This one? What could go wrong? No, nothing could go wrong.
Whatever supplies you need.
Video games still haven't quite made it when it comes to collision stuff. You know what I mean? It's like, we got close, but then that can still happen very, very easily.
If you neutralize an enemy without killing him, you can then Fulton extract him.
All right,
once you've extracted a soldier, we should be able to convince
I'm gonna
him
save
to join
this
us.
And go to bed now. Staff management. Oh, you can upgrade manually. If you have the right materials, you can make the base bigger and stuff, huh? It's very, very cool. It's Peace Walker, but a lot more in-depth. So how do I save? Just push escape or start and go to the title. Return to title menu. I know it auto-saves, I just didn't want to, lose the shower progress, you know, that was very important. How's your heart been beating? How's your skin been keeping? Don't remember the rest of the words. Alright. Let's see what art we have tonight. Man, I just want to point out that my first stream of this game has been very, very, very fun. And I love this game. I love it. Love it, love it. It's great. And it's weird because starting with Metal Gear Solid 3, then going to Peace Walker, then Ground Zeroes, and then this. It's been, like I said before, you would have thought I would have Metal Gear fatigue. Nope. It's different enough. It's more in-depth to the point where I really, really don't... I don't mind. What's that? Yeah, I really don't mind. I'm having a lot of fun with it, and I feel like this is a classic game. I think this is going to be revered as one of the best in the series, just from a gameplay standpoint so far, just because of how fun it is. It may end up being, you know, by the end of the game, maybe it won't be as good, but it's poised, in my unprofessional opinion, it's poised to be a very, very exciting and good game, and I think it's going to be awesome. From Enzific, here's the Fox logo, kind of vine saucerized. It's really good. From Muffin Seeker. The position of the snake. My God. That is perfect, isn't it? Oh, I love it. Okay. From Kieran 11. Cardboard gear. Peace Walker. From Chuck Bartowski. Here's a BRB. From Joel. I hate you. I regret that selfie now. Very much so. From Curie Curie Mix. Oh my god, what is it with the butts? There's a drawing of me now. From Makuta's bastard son, there's Dee Dee being lifted on the Fulton. From Detective Agent. Radicool. I think that's actually from Joel. It's tagged Joel, so maybe the word radicool happened that I'm unaware of it. But that's pretty much it. It's just a little bit of art tonight. So remember, if you guys want to submit art, there's a few rules you can check out, but vinesauce.boru.org, B-O-O-R-U. And you can, if you've never submitted art before and you want to and you don't know how, you can just Google it. Just type Vinesauce Boru, B-O-O-R-U, and you'll get there. And then if you look at the top there, you will see, when you click posts, you'll see forum, and you can see the rules. So, but anyway, this was a lot of fun. Thank you guys for tolerating this Metal Gear overload. I'm usually more of a variety type streamer, but it's been a very Metal Gear life for me the past 3 months or so, whatever, 2 months, and it's been a lot of fun. Tomorrow, I think there's definitely going to be some variety, maybe even a guest appearance by Mike. We're kind of planning something, maybe something fun for tomorrow. And also, I think tomorrow, I may start South Park tomorrow, Stick of Truth. So I'll see how things are going. I might do like an early-ish stream because later on Mike is coming over and then my friend Tyler might come by. He's off from work up until like a certain point, like he's a teacher. So he's going back to work soon. And this is like, honestly, we just haven't had the opportunity to hang out. And when it comes to Tyler, or as you guys call him, Tyrone, when it comes to Tyler, we just kind of watch like movies. We watched Zero Theorem. That was the most recent one we watched. And tomorrow, I think, what the hell were we going to watch tomorrow? Whoa, where'd that come from? I forgot. Usually we watch bad movies, like just schlocky crap. But I think we've been kind of showing each other movies. And also, Zero Theorem was not that amazing. None of us had seen it. And by the end of it, we were just talking. Just making fun of shit. It wasn't even like... It was tough. But I actually don't hate that movie. It's just not amazing. It's Gilliam... It's riddled with Gilliamisms. Gilliamisms. Which are... If you've ever seen some of the later Gilliam movies, and even some of the earlier ones, that's not always a good thing. But anyway, yeah, that's just not a good recommendation. If I have any other good recommendations for you guys, you know, I'll definitely let you know about it. For whoever asked me what I thought of the movie Interstellar, just on a side note, I think that's a really fun movie. I like it a lot. I watched it in IMAX, and I loved it visually. However, it is a little bit up its own ass at times. But I don't think it really detracts from the movie too much. I really, really enjoyed it. And I came out of that theater a very happy patron. I felt like I got my money's worth. So, yeah, Interstellar was cool. All right, now that's it for real. You guys are amazing, as always. Thank you for the help tonight. And thank you for hanging out. I'll see you soon. Good night.